Okay, so here's what's wrong. We got one very broken propeller, and then we got like a few that are, I don't know, need some TLC, and we got a little portion of the front that's busted. This drone has been crashed, and we're gonna fix it today. To be honest, I think it's gonna be fine, but if you're in a similar situation, let's fix our drones together. I'm gonna be taking you through some helpful things to know coming up. And if you're new here, yo, I'm Christine Lozada. This is Drone with CL. I love helping people to explore the world of drone from the sky. So much fun. I have courses, I have blog posts, one that goes with it, and so much more. Check the resources in the description. There are three things I'm taking you through today. One, let's change those propellers together. Two, then let's calibrate our drone in three ways to make sure it's ready for its test flight. And three, the key thing that we are gonna do during the test flight to make sure we are safe when we are getting back to the sky with our drones. Are you ready to rock and roll? You need four items. Let's go grab our drone and the controller, spare propellers. Every newer DJI drone comes with spare propellers, grab that. Depending on your type of drone, you need the tool. Go grab the little itty bitty tool. And the last thing you need, what is it? Oh, get your battery charging. So if your battery's totally dead, get it charging now while we are doing the propellers. And let's go change the propellers. We've got good news here, which is the newer DJI drones make it very easy to figure out which propeller goes on which side. So you're simply looking at the propeller and it will show you which portion of the drone it has to go on. So just match those up. And if you're wondering, what if I put it on the wrong one on accident? We'll talk about how to triple make sure, but basically your drone won't come off the ground. I have done this before with the DJI FPV drone, not my favorite drone, but basically for that drone at least, it will not take off the ground. It just kind of bucks around and stuff. But match up our propellers, and then we're going to take off the screws if that's the type of drone you have. This is the Mavic Mini 3 Pro, and so I'm just switching out the propellers, or at least the ones that are the most broken, and making sure that they are on the correct sides. So there's two ways I know that I've put the correct propellers on. The first one is the indicators. So here on the instructions, it will show you the correct side, but even though I know I'm following the correct side, there's something else that's still making me feel good. So I know, for example, it's not upside down because it has the DJI printing on the front of the propeller. And so I can see that the name is on the front. And so this was the old broken one, right? It has this like nick here. And so when I have these two brand new ones on here, it's showing in the correct direction, right? They're both going the same way versus these ones on the bottom. So these propellers are different than these propellers, right? Because this one and this one are the same, and this one and that one are the same. God, I love that focus. But here you can see these two are, you know, they're matching up, right? And the DJI logo is kind of going in the same direction this way versus I'm looking at them matching up, and the DJI is on top, right? So they're not upside down going that way. And everything's just matching up and looking correct before I go to the next step. Let's turn on the drone, because before we want to put this thing in the air, we want to get everything calibrated. Basically, the drone has just done a whole like da 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 da. And we want to help it basically have a relaxation massage so it gets back to normal before it takes to the sky. And when I say relaxation massage, I mean calibrating it. So we're gonna calibrate a few things just to make sure everything is right and tight. So let's get to that. I feel like I've spent half my life waiting for this drone to turn on. Huh? Ready now? All right. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we are going to calibrate the drone. We're gonna do the normal calibration first, and then I'm gonna just, for funsies, just in case, calibrate the gimbal, because the last thing I want is to be shooting something and realizing, oh, the gimbal's not working correctly. So first, I'm gonna go to the three dots on the top right, and under safety, I'm scrolling down. I'm scrolling down to sensors where it says compass normal. I'm gonna click on calibrate. So calibrate. And it says here on the screen, in case you don't know it, keep clear of metal, or objects with electrical charge. So this is a difficult thing to do if you're inside of a car. I still try to do it all the time. And ensure the distance between the aircraft and the ground is around 1.5 meters. So I'm gonna press start. I definitely do this on the ground all the time, if I'm honest. Rotate horizontally. You don't have to spin around. You can spin it in your hands. I always laugh when people act like ballerinas. If you've wanted to be a ballerina your whole life, this could be your moment, just saying. Rotate vertically, up, rotating it vertically. Calibration successful, love to hear that. Now I'm gonna put it on a flat surface and I'm gonna do the next part of calibration. Three dots on the top right. And now I'm going to go to IMU normal and I'm gonna press calibrate. And do you see how the drone now is folded up on the screen? So I am going to match it up and do the same thing. Fold it on up, tuck it in like it's going to bed. I'm gonna set it down and I'm going to start. Place aircraft on a level surface, boom. Calibrate the aircraft as shown. Only move the aircraft when prompted. So basically just do the things. Press start. And now it's gonna take its sweet time to make sure it's getting calibrated. And it says here, right, keep it powered on. So I'm keeping everything powered on. You can see it's doing its thing with the lights, etc. Keeping this powered on, ain't touching nothing. All right, so now we're gonna lay on its side. So just like the image, I'm gonna lay it on its side. Boom, now it's gonna do it that way and I'll actually pay attention this time. There we go, now it's ready to go upside down. I'm gonna go upside down. Now it's, you know, sleepless night. It's gonna go on its back. Now it's on its back. Boom, come on, do the thing. Killing my battery here, Willis. Cool, ready to go on the other side. Sleepless night, rolling onto its side now. Maybe I can get some sleep this way. We're almost there. Hoo-hoo. This one you might want to hold on to just in case. Oh, no. Look at that yoga pose. Ooh, restarting the aircraft. All right, now put it back. Right, just like the image, tuck it in again. And it's gonna restart itself. And I'm going to be patient. I'm not very good at that. Love to see that. It says calibration successful. All right. Hey, I want to interrupt to say if you're getting some value out of this video, cheers that like button, consider subscribing. If you have a helpful tip, add it in the comments. We're all a community. I've only crashed my drone twice, three times, once in Ethiopia and this time in Mexico, and it wasn't a great story. I talk about it honestly in the Why I Hate Flying in Tulum video. You can check that out in the description below. It's not easy for me to share these things. You're also welcome to join us in the Facebook group. There's so many resources. Check the description and let's get back to it. Okay, so we finished calibrating the drone from a flying perspective. I feel good about it, but I wanna make sure I still get the shots I'm looking for today. I'm gonna calibrate the gimbal just in case. This is not a safety setting. So we're gonna go from safety over to control. And under control, I'm scrolling down to gimbal. And under gimbal, you have the option for gimbal calibration. So I'm gonna click on that and the same thing, I'm gonna follow these instructions. It's telling me to open it up, baby. And we are gonna place aircraft on a level surface. Fine, you can take my coffee spot and we're gonna do auto. So let's do an auto calibration here. And we're gonna let it do its thing. I'm not gonna touch anything. I'm gonna enjoy the rest of this coffee. That was actually pretty fast. Calibration successful, love that. I've also made sure, since obviously the gimbal cover was off when my drone crashed, that I've cleaned the front of the lens. And I actually have a filter on here. Check out my filter video in case you're like, oh, what about filters? So I'm about to take my drone outside to fly it and make sure it's flying just fine. There are a couple things I'm thinking about. First, it's hot outside today. So before I get outside, I just quickly am going to update the FlySafe database and the firmware. Because the last thing I wanna do is get outside, try to take off and realize, oh, there's an update and I spend 20 minutes standing outside wasting even more battery. And do I need to change the battery before I go out there? I was fine on this front. The second thing, I'm gonna go fly my drone in the backyard and no higher than just probably 5 feet, to be honest. I just want to make sure the drone can fly. And this is for two reasons. One, you don't want to just blast your drone, because what if something is wrong? I'm going to let that thing hover for a really long time at a very low height. If for some reason it has an issue, I want it to have an issue close to the ground and not 200 feet up. The second is, and this is an etiquette thing, I very rarely will fly near any houses or homes unless I must, because I'm making sure my drone can fly before I actually go on project tomorrow. And so in this case, I'm gonna go in the backyard. Why? I'm not flying it higher than, I'm not that tall. I'm not flying it higher than me or somewhere my neighbors can see. A lot of people don't understand this. Your neighbors don't want to be excited about, hey, I have this item that can look all around your backyard, even though I'm not looking. And I'll share a story with you about that at the end, but it's just an etiquette thing. A lot of people don't understand that. No one's excited to hear that their neighbor has a drone. So I'm gonna take it in the backyard where neighbors will not see me, and I will keep it extremely low, both for my drone safety and not to annoy my neighbors. Let's go fly. Yes, I did have a good feeling about my drone being just fine. Let's recap what we learned today. First, we changed the propellers, and we learned that there are key indicators that tell you which side the propellers need to go on, but you can also make sure you haven't put them on upside down or on the wrong parts by matching up the DJI labels and making sure they're all right and tight and facing kind of the correct reading direction. The next thing is we calibrated, right? We calibrated the regular calibration, the IMU, and the gimbal. So we went through all of that and making sure we have a full battery and our FlySafe database and our firmware is updated. Then we took our drones outside for its test flight. And on that test flight, we made sure it had plenty of room. And once we took off, we let it chill for a while. This is not the day to go crazy on sport mode, flying fast and high with your drone. You just wanna make sure you're all good to go. Yes, I did do a couple twirlies and just a small bit of movement, but it wasn't something where I just needed to make sure the thing still was flying just fine. Cheers that like button. Join us in the Facebook group. So many more resources in the description. Add your helpful tip below, and I'll see ya in the next one. Ciao. So here's a story that I actually think is important and kind of sheds light on why you shouldn't fly in a neighborhood or near housing, et cetera. I mean, no one is excited, right, about drones near their personal homes. And there's so many times I've flown a drone in which I wasn't even looking at the neighbors' houses. Like, there's a time that I was practicing time lapses and hyperlapses. You can check out that video in my course, actually. And I put the drone at 400 feet up, right above my boyfriend's house. And it was looking out at this stunning sunset. And I let it sit there for an entire battery, around 21 minutes, filming this hyperlapse, staying in place. And so I could speed that up and turn it into a beautiful 5 second kind of, oh, the sunset today. And you know what happened? Immediately, about 5 minutes later, someone knocked on the front door, because I very rarely fly at the house. Someone, oh, did you know there's a drone hovering over your house? Like, oh, actually, that's my drone. Like, I was capturing the sunset. And so it's not abnormal for people to be looking out for you, because drones are so frequently used by people who just ruin it for everybody and spy on other people. I will admit, I have spied before with my drone. There was an alligator out front, and I didn't want to walk up to the alligator, but I really wanted to see. Drone was perfect in that situation. You can tell me in the comments below if that's considered spying, but anyway. Which, by the way, if you haven't seen that viral clip of the alligator eating the drone, there's no reason for that. 4K, 2X zoom, you can keep the drone so far away while getting an amazing clip of something like an alligator without it being anywhere close to that alligator being able to grab it out of the air. All right, that's an aside. Hope that helped.